When it comes to Encompass, obviously it runs the mortgage industry. And in order to run the mortgage industry and underwrite files, you need conditions. What we're going to go over here is, what is the difference? What is the big deal about standard conditions versus enhanced conditions? There's been a lot of talk recently about moving to enhanced conditions, but it's really important to understand, what is the value proposition? That's what we're going to talk about in this video. And if you like this video and like this content, please go ahead and click the like button. Go ahead and click the subscribe button, and we'll get into it now, all about enhanced conditions and what's the value proposition. So what is an enhanced condition is important to understand based upon what is a standard condition. We've been using Encompass for 20 years, and this is an example of a standard condition. We have it showing up here on screen where we've got the name and the description, if it's associated with a particular document found in the e-folder, obviously category, what's it prior to, these are all preset, you can't modify them, as well as who's the owner of this condition, i.e. who's responsible for modifying it, and are they allowed to clear it as far as the status. Does it print internally or externally on any documentation, of course, relevant for the TPO? That's all great. And again, this has been the way it has been for 20 years. And so when you look at the condition, you see the name and the description. That's all you get. You also don't have any native functionality beyond this. So what's all about the enhanced conditions, and why are these things so important? I'm going to point out a couple of things first of all. When you go into an enhanced condition, one of the things that you're going to want to see right away is the type. Now, this is a brand new kind of way to manage your conditions. So when you go into the e-folder, there's only one tab, but you have multiple types of conditions you can add in there. What you see in here is what you're used to seeing based upon the tabs from standard conditions, but you can create any condition type that you want. So to show you what that looks like, you can come over into these condition types and you can create anything that you want. We've got some situations where folks are adding in the condition type of loan processor to clear, or underwriter to clear, or post-closer to clear. You can also think about condition types specifically for a loan type, so for an FHA or conventional, or a QM or non-QM. Really, the sky is the limit. And what's really neat, what's really important, is you finally get to manage your own categories and your own prior tos, as well as source options. And then last but not least, down here in the tracking options, you get to really focus in on what do you want that particular role to be able to do with that particular condition type relevant to the statuses and the tracking options that you've put in here. So all of this is completely customizable, and that's just one value prop for the enhanced conditions. The next value prop for the enhanced conditions is looking at the condition itself. So when we look at this enhanced condition, what we're seeing is we've got, first of all, an internal ID as well as an external ID, and hidden up here in the top corner is active or not active. So if we want to deactivate a condition, we can actually keep that condition in our condition settings here without actually losing it. We can actually remove it from current visibility to your teams by deactivating that condition. That's a really big deal for condition management. Also, the name is that, it's just a name. The internal description is what the internal team will see when they look in Encompass and look at that condition. The external description is what the public will see, or the other parties that are looking at the approval letters or the condition letters that you might publish out to everybody outside of your company. So right now you get to have a complete, separate, distinct internal description as well as an external description. And then you get into your documents, which you're familiar with, and you get into your owner, which is what you're familiar with. Now, these settings are going to depend upon what type. So we can see if we go ahead and change the condition type, these are all going to update based upon the settings that you made in the condition types that we went through earlier. So as you go through this, you can also check the effective date. So if you wanted a condition to either start by a certain time or end by a certain time without worrying about activating or deactivating manually, you can do that if you wanted to. So this is really good for programs that are launching in the future, or for programs that are stopping in the future, you can set those end dates. So all of those conditions will just either automatically activate or automatically deactivate. Now, one of the things that I wanted to make sure that you understood is when we get into the idea of using these conditions, I want you to understand the automation is really where it's at. So with Encompass Web, you have the ability for these utilities to come over here and process automation and workflow rules, to be able to come over and create a brand new rule. And using that brand new rule, you can create different trigger events that you're used to, whether that's milestone completion, or you have different roles assigned, or you have different documents added, files attached, all these kinds of opportunities for triggering events. It's the result that's important, because for the very first time with enhanced conditions, natively, you can not only add your enhanced conditions to the e-folder directly, natively, you can also update those enhanced conditions tracking status. So this is very important for everybody's workflow to make sure that when you go through and you look at what is the difference between conditions or enhanced conditions, you've got your condition types, you've got all of the different ways you can manage that condition in terms of internal description, external description, as well as tracking IDs. You've got the ability to activate or deactivate those conditions. And then last but not least, you have the ability to automate those conditions in your Encompass platform. So if you ever have any questions, just go ahead and list them in the comments below. We'll go ahead and give them answers. If you ever want to learn how to use this effectively as an administrator, head over to masteringencompass.com and get more information as you go. Again, please give us a like and subscribe to the channel for more information as we release it. Thank you.